Zooming in on the land, we need to know the land reform policy implemented by Mugabe in 2000. White people comprised 4% of the population, yet they owned most of the land. The government attempted to fix this by expropriating their lands and redistributing it to local blacks. Zimbabwe's economy can be divided into two sectors: commercial agriculture of crops like cotton, tobacco, coffee, peanuts and fruits, and subsistence farming with major crops like corn and wheat. Local Zimbabweans were never educated about commercial farming, and they were unable to work because they had neither agriculture technology nor management funds. On top of that, the drought has left farmers poor, and the volume of agricultural exports were dropped sharply. Zimbabwe's national budget, which relies on the agricultural economy, must have run out. Land reform aimed at white people. Bad economic conditions caused many foreign companies to turn their backs on Zimbabwe, and foreign capital began to slip away when international organizations drastically reduced the amount of aid they gave to Zimbabwe. As foreign exchange reserves became empty, domestic companies in Zimbabwe were on the verge of bankruptcy. In order to solve this problem, Mugabe began by printing money too hard. This excessive currency issue has caused inflation. If there is too much money on the market, the value of money will inevitably. In fact, 10 years ago, the Zimbabwean economy was on the verge of collapse, described by the Korean government agency KUTRA, an agency that helps Korean companies do business in Africa. KUTRA attributed the impending collapse to the failure of the land reform, murderous inflation rate, unemployment rate, and foreign exchange depletion. Even after Mugabe's resignation, Zimbabwe's economy has not been in a good state. There is also a contrary public opinion that the socio-economic situation was better during Mugabe's presidency. More than 60% of Zimbabwe's market is informal. This does not mean black markets. Rather, the informal sector consists of informal enterprises which are too small to be called cooperative. There are, however, a small group of people that legally make money by selling goods but remain unregistered or unlicensed. It is a normal and legally operated market. They are just not registered, so cannot be counted as contributors to the real GDP. Zimbabwe has a lot to do. They need to eradicate corruption, refund the education system, infrastructure, and boost the agricultural sector. Since they have enough working population and resources that is heavily possible, we look forward to the days of partnering more with Zimbabwe in the future.